Congrats, Clint. Good luck.
These two seem to be matching each other pre-fight, move for move, intensity for intensity, bounce for bounce.
Yeah, that must have been the most angry pre-fight stare down I've seen in a long time.
Both these guys not afraid to mix it up. And as they both said, they're going to go fast and furious. Cruz in the red trunks, McCall in the black.
Cruz tried to lead in there, he and McCall tried to lead with that lead hook. Got caught with an uppercut on the outside.
Because if I make a comment about his hairstyle, he might come find me. If you do it, you're bigger than he is. McCall working on the takedown.
Oh, he got the neck a little deep there.
McCall coming with some knees. Dominick Cruz finds himself up against the cage and with his proverbial back against the wall trying to figure out how to stop this onslaught.
Good job of nullifying it so far. What a nice lateral drop. Man. That was a pretty high-level wrestling move there. Extremely impressive for Dominick Cruz to get the takedown, but was able to throw him and call off balance. That way he was able to get off of the cage.
There's an example right there, the lightning-fast speed of Dominick Cruz.
Yeah, and also the height advantage here. McCall keeps dropping his hands. He's lifting his elbows up to protect his face.
Cruz has already landed a couple blows.
He's going for a knee tap there with the underhook. Good strength from Ian McCall actually to stop that. Dominick Cruz kind of had his number there with the knee tap.
One went for the leg, the other for the arm. McCall has to backpedal. Cruz lands another one.
And McCall's quick at changing levels. He does it at the right time also. He's not really just blindly shooting in. You see he throws a nice hand combination and he's shooting off of that. Dominick Cruz though has the advantage on the stand-up from what I see so far due to the height. And speed-wise, I don't even know which guy to get the edge to, but height means a lot, reach means a lot in the striking.
Those blows of Cruz certainly aren't falling under the radar. He's telegraphing them, Frank, pretty well, but they're still so lightning fast.
He is, and he's also kind of hiding his movements with his, the fact he's moving his body side to side, so he kind of hides.
Cruz comes in with a couple punches and then the kick.
See a lot more kicks. You see he's using kind of a little bit of the Dutch style there with his feet, switching them back and forth. See how, and that's allowed him to set up a lot of kicks because that way you don't know really which leg is loaded. See how he keeps switching his feet? He's kind of like dancing left leg, right leg, left leg. By doing so, you never really have a beat on what leg is the power going to come from.
Just under a minute and a half left in round number one, and still it's Cruz advancing, but right there McCall had an answer.
Again, due to the height advantage of Dominick Cruz, striking ability. The combination of Dominick Cruz is beautiful. You see he's throwing hand combinations, the hook, do a switch kick to the head. And the time. That's all off of combinations, too. You see how he's not just loading up on the roundhouse. He threw a combination of left hook, straight right hand, and he came back up with the left roundhouse.
Under 40 seconds here in round number one. As expected, a fast pace between these bantamweights. getting set to start our second round of a possible three between Ian McCall and Dominick Cruz. You can see the cut under McCall's left eye. That happened early in the round because Cruz was throwing some big leather, Frank.
He was. Also, too, you know, the one thing besides the damage to the eye that I see, Ian McCall's left leg, the way he's moving around, even one of those roundhouses to the thigh actually did a lot more damage. You can see again, he's having a hard time putting weight on his left leg.
Cruz able to size up McCall and just come in.
As the shorter opponent, it's hard to move backwards. You want to actually close the distance and keep that fight tighter. So to move backwards against a taller guy makes it difficult because you're constantly moving out of your range, and it's a lot easier for him to move within his range.
Wrestling backgrounds. It's been primarily a stand-up battle. Dominick Cruz, Frank, into moving the way he wants him to set up one of those shots.
He's doing that with his hands. You see his hand combination moves, you know, Dominick Cruz's body. So that way he can set up and get his weight right where he wants to, put Ian McCall right in the right spot to deliver a brilliant finishing blow. I feel that he's looking towards the roundhouse.
Under 3 minutes to go in round number two.
Opponents down and impose his will with his relentless pace from the ground and pound area. So right now, having a kickboxing match with Dominick Cruz, he's not really pulling off the level. He's losing the edge here.
Right, certainly not playing to his strengths.
No, but you know, that's not any fault to his own. He's looking to get the fight to the ground. Just Dominick Cruz has grappling to avoid
Great job so far by Dominick Cruz to really implement his game plan. Under 2 minutes now in round two. This round settled down a little bit as you would expect compared to the pace in round one, but still Dominick Cruz advances.
Ian McCall's a tough guy. He just took a shit across the chin. And most guys don't laugh about that.
Now under 90 seconds to go.
Slick on his feet.
Both these guys keeping their promise to push the pace. Another left hand lands for Cruz. Another left kick.
Outside there, you see he stepped his right foot outside of Ian McCall's leg and was able to deliver that right uppercut right on the chin.
30 seconds scheduled for three. Dominick Cruz in the red, Ian McCall in the black.
McCall kind of threw that hook blindly.
Another great left kick.
You don't see that in the heavyweight classes. Two guys fall to their knees and immediately jump up and throw a kick to the head.
Cruz in the red trunks, McCall in the black trunks. Frank, at this point, do you give both those first two rounds to Cruz?
I think it would be pretty easy to say that Dominick Cruz is commanding a two-round lead in this fight.
Cruz's last fight went three, and he won a unanimous decision over Charlie Valencia.
Again with a nice slick uppercut. See how he faced the outside of the lose that uppercut. That was a roundhouse, straight right hand combination. At this point, as long as Dominick Cruz doesn't fall asleep, the fight stays at this pace.
Credit McCall, as you mentioned, for taking a lot of shots. Dominick Cruz.
You're right. That kick he took in round two to the shin.
Packs a wallop, coming with a lot of velocity. Cruz has had a great camp, it seems. Still moving as quickly as he did in round number one.
And McCall coming in, not throwing a punch at first, and ran right into the right hand.
Title shot. Torres is in no hurry to give that belt up. That cut under the left eye really starting to bleed now. Ian McCall is taking a couple more shots right there. Coming up on 3 minutes left in round number three.
So far, in my opinion, only taking a superior strike from Dominick Cruz, and he has shown no signs of trying to quit. He's coming forward with a lot of guts, and pushing and trying to figure out a way to win this fight. Most guys are getting, outstruck to this point. They look for a way out, and they just fold up and lose to their loss.
Cruz moving forward. The combinations continue. Finishes with that kick. Dominick Cruz has inflicted some serious damage on Ian McCall. Minutes left in the fight.
Great takedown defensively. There, he got taken down to his back, got up to his hips, and up to his feet. Ian McCall coming with the knee afterwards, but Dominick Cruz.
Get inside, and every time he's done it, I think it's been three times, he's been able to try to get a knee in the face of Cruz, but Cruz gets out.
Nice uppercut again. Couldn't find a home for that shot out of his hand techniques. That one, what you're saying, a lot of people were devastating hand techniques he's thrown tonight.
75 seconds to go. Neither fighter content to sit on his heels. They're advancing on each other for the first time. It looked as though Dominick Cruz looked off to his corner to see just what he should continue to do, but now he's focused yet again on Ian McCall. Another run. Joe Martinez is inside the cage with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to three rounds of action inside the cage, we go to the scorecard. The same 30-27 for your winner by unanimous pride of San Diego.